Hi, I am Benila. In this video, I am going to explain the vector diagram of an AC distribution system. The distribution system has feeders and distributors. A feeder is a conductor which connects the substation to the area where the power is to be distributed. Generally, no tappings are taken from the feeder so that the current in it remains the same. A distributor is a conductor from which tappings are taken for supply to consumers. We are going to draw the vector diagram of this AC distributor. Consider an AC distributor AB with concentrated loads of I1 and I2 tapped off at points C and B. The distributor is fed by a feeder. Here, the sending end voltage is the node voltage VA and the receiving end voltage is the node voltage VB. The load voltages are VC and VB. Since this is the AC system, there will be voltage drops due to the combined effects of resistance, inductance and capacitance. Let R1 X1 and R2 X2 be the resistance and reactance of AC and CB sectors. Another important factor we should consider is power factor. It is the cosine angle between voltage and current. Loads tapped off from the distributor are generally at different power factors. Let us consider our power factors as cos phi1 and cos phi2. There are two ways to represent this power factor. The first one is with respect to the receiving end voltage and the second one is with respect to the load voltage. Let's first discuss the first case. Here, the phi1 is the phase difference between the current I1 and the receiving end voltage VB. Phi2 is the phase difference between the current I2 and the receiving end voltage VB. Now, let's represent these I1, I2 and VB in vector diagram. Let's take VB as a reference vector. A vector has a magnitude and direction. It's simply represented by an arrow. Here, the length represents the magnitude and the arrowhead represents the direction. Next, let's represent I2. Since that load has a lagging power factor of cos phi2, the current I2 lags the voltage VB by an angle phi2. Similarly, I1 lags the voltage VB by an angle phi1. Look at this symbolic notation. Can you find the equation for VC? It is the sum of the voltage drop in the CB section and the node voltage VB. VC is equal to I2 into R2 plus JX2 plus VB. Now let's represent this VC in our vector diagram. Let's start with this I2 R2. We already have I2 vector. When it is multiplied with a constant R2, its magnitude increases. Now we have got our I2 R2. Next is JI2 X2. Similar to the previous one, we have I2 vector. When it is multiplied with a constant X2, its magnitude increases. Now this is I2 X2, but we need JI2 X2. It has the same magnitude but different direction. JI2 X2 will be perpendicular to I2 X2. Now we have got our JI2 X2. VB is already present in our vector diagram. To represent VC, we need to add all these three vectors. How to add vectors? There are mainly two methods, head-to-tail method and parallelogram method. In the head-to-tail method, the head of the vector is connected to the tail of the successive vector. The resultant vector is drawn from the tail of the first vector to the head of the last vector. When two vectors are placed at the same initial point, we have to use the parallelogram method. Here, we have to form a parallelogram. The diagonal of the parallelogram is the resultant vector. In our case, we can use the head-to-tail method. It is very clear that the resultant vector is VC. Now, let's come back to our symbolic representation. From here, can you find the equation for the sending end voltage VA? Let's consider the current through the section AC is IAC. Then VA is equal to IAC into R1 plus JX1 plus VC. What is IAC? IAC is equal to I1 plus I2. Now, let's represent these equations in the vector diagram. IAC can be found using the parallelogram law. Now, we can find IAC R1 and JIAC X1. We already have VC in our vector diagram. Using the head-to-tail method, we can find the resultant VA. That's all. The vector diagram is done. Now we know the sending end voltage VA and the sending end current IAC. This angle represents the phase difference between the sending end voltage and current. Let's see the next case. The power factor with respect to load voltages. Here, Phi1 is the phase angle between I1 and VC and Phi2 is the phase angle between I2 and VB. Let's draw the vector diagram under these conditions. First, the reference vector VB. Next, I2 lags the voltage VB by an angle Phi2. We cannot represent I1 yet because we still don't have VC in our diagram. So, let's represent the VC first. For that, we need I2 R2 and then JI2 X2. The resultant of these three vectors is VC. Now we can draw I1. I1 lags the voltage VC by an angle Phi1. The resultant of I1 and I2 gives IAC. Now we can find IAC R1 and JIAC X1. We already have VC in our vector diagram. Using the head-to-tail method, we can find the resultant VA. That's all. If you have any doubt, let me know in the comment section below. Bye. See you in my next video.